Hey everyone, welcome back to Abyss Odyssey, super late night, Googlepocalypse edition. I say Googlepocalypse because Google bought Twitch officially for $1 billion and everyone's kind of freaking out. I don't know, I'll wait and see how they handle it before I start really worrying. I doubt they're going to mess it up too badly. It's probably going to be run pretty much the same way it has been, at least for a while. I mean, they might do some, like, Google Plus integration and stuff, but, I don't know. Wait and see. If you're watching this on YouTube, the Wednesday stream did go up. Most of you probably missed it because, for whatever reason, it's stuck in YouTube processing hell. Like, it's been in the publishing to subscriber feeds phase for, like, the past 2 days, and the video's only gotten, like, 6 views, but, you know, if you go to my YouTube page, you should find it there. No one in the chat room, which I was expecting, you know, surprise stream at 11:42 p.m. Eastern Time. I doubt many people will show up, but, you know, I was playing and I thought, what the hell, I might as well just plug my microphone in. So I still have quite a few enemies to unlock here, and I don't actually know what most of these are. It is kind of frustrating. I was confused about this big one that looks like a bull, but I'm pretty sure that's the living creature. Because I think these are the only two bulls, the golden calf and the camahueto. So the only other enemy that would be this large is the living creature. And then this one, with, like, the antlers, that's, like, the warlock. Because he has, like, the branches on his head. The cranberry bush. And the rest of these, I don't know what the hell they are. Yeah, I thought maybe I was missing the skeleton warrior, but no, I have him. I have... Man, I don't know. I'm going to have to, I'm going to have to try to figure this out. I mean, I do still need to get, Paganini. I don't have him yet. So, Paganini, Living Creature, and Warlock. That's three. At least three enemies that I still haven't captured, and I have no idea what they are. Oh, well. Let's go on ahead and get started. I had a really successful run as the monk earlier, and I've almost got the achievement for getting him all the way leveled up. Wow, look at that. Look at the Santa Lucia path. It's almost all... Oh, no, I guess it's just... It's mostly moderate. There are no hard at all in that path. That's kind of weird. But still, that's a lot of moderate. There are three arena rooms, though, so... That should be helpful. So I realized that there were two abilities that I still haven't picked up. I didn't pick up the one... Well, I didn't pick up either of the abilities in the other two locations, because there's one in Santa Lucia that's on the other side of this pit here, and then there's one in Pokuro Park and one in the Cathedral, and I didn't pick up those two at all. So I picked those up, and they're pretty nice abilities. I've been sticking with them. So here's what I have. I still have big ol' wind-up charge, which has served me quite well. And I also have the sword uppercut one, and then just plain old nice quick forward slash. And those three have comboed together pretty well. Also, the monk has way more hit points than the other two characters do, because I'm level 30 and I already have more than 2,000, which is... Pretty sure that's scaling faster than the other two characters did. So I got one warlock kill with the monk. And it was a really good battle too. I went into the warlock. I had like 3/4 health. Maybe a little more than that. I am mostly full health, but I didn't have a creature with me. And I managed to kill the warlock without needing the assistance of one of the soldiers. I didn't die at all in that fight. I was like, damn, I wish I was streaming this one. And then, after the fight, I switched over to Pincoya, and I went to Pokura Park, hoping for a living creature fight, and I got one. The living creature showed up. I switched to Pincoya because I think she's a high enough level to capture the living creature. And I beat him. I defeated the living creature. But right before I killed him, I threw out my capture ability. And he just jumped right over it. That son of a bitch just completely ruined my plans to capture him, which made me quite angry. So hopefully I'll have another successful run tonight, and I'll have another shot at picking up the living creature. Still not even close to being able to capture the Warlock, of course. I don't know, I've seen conflicting sources. I've seen some people say he's level 60 and some people say he's level 70. I'm pretty sure the developers themselves said he's level 60 in the Steam forums for this game. So I'll take their word for it. Maybe he was level 70 and they nerfed him. So yeah, at least halfway towards being able to capture the Warlock, which is fine. I still need to figure out what the three creatures I still need to capture are, other than the three that I know about. And I need to beat it on Nightmare. Or I need to at least try to beat it on Nightmare. And then if I can pull that off, which I think I might be able to do, then that would be all the achievements. This would be the first game that I ever got 100% of the achievements in, except for The Walking Dead Season 1. But that doesn't really count, because all of the achievements in that are just for playing the game. Like, there's nothing special you have to do to get all the achievements in The Walking Dead. It came pretty damn close to getting all the achievements in Shovel Knight. All I have to do is beat the game without dying, beat the game without falling into a pit, and beat the game without spending any money. Oh wait, no, I have four. Beat the game without spending any money, and I still need the speedrun achievement. And for a while, after I finished Shovel Knight, after I finished some of the difficult achievements, I tried going for the speedrunning / no death achievement quite a few times, and I eventually gave up on it. I might go back to revisit that one someday, mostly because I really love Shovel Knight. If nothing else, I need to do a full Shovel Knight stream at some point. Because I played the game a little bit on Hitbox, but I wasn't talking or anything. It was just me making failed attempts at speedrunning over and over again. Which I was going about it the wrong way, because, well, A, I probably shouldn't have been going for both of those achievements at the same time. I should have gone for either the speedrun or the no-death achievement. Doing both was setting myself up for failure. And B, when I did die, I shouldn't have started over every time. Because what ended up happening was I didn't make it past, I think the farthest I made it was, I made it about three bosses in. And every time I die, I would just start over because, you know, that's it. I missed the chance of beating the game without dying. And I should have just kept going just to get practice, you know, playing the tougher areas of the game over and over again. But, you know, that's a little demoralizing, too. So, I don't know. I mean, I am not very good at speedrunning, and I am not very good at playing the game super carefully. Ooh, that mirror necklace would be pretty nice. I'll take it. Have I gotten any more skill points? No. See, all I need one more skill point. And I got the achievement for maxing out the monk. I have to say, fighting pretty well so far. I took some damage, but I leveled up, so I'm back up to full health. I have a full mana bar. I'm kind of saving it just in case there are any enemies I find that I don't think I've captured yet. But, like, playing through the game a couple times before I started streaming, I'm pretty sure I've captured everything. Like, I don't know what I could be missing besides the Warlock, Paganini, and the Living Creature. And, you know, those are all way too high level for me to get with the monk, so... So I don't know, I don't know what I'm missing. Incorrect weapon type. Who died and made you the Pope of Swords? I don't see why I couldn't use that weapon if I wanted to. Just because it's a rapier and not a two-handed sword. And I'm pretty sure the monk could handle it. Of course, he's not nearly as fast as Catrian, so it would probably not be very good for him. I have a really nice three-part combo with the monk specials. I'll try to pull it off here. Maybe when I'm not fighting so many of these guys. But basically, I do that. Well, I timed that very poorly. But basically, I just do all three of my specials in a row, and then the last move of the combo is very slow, but I have one cancel point left, so I can dodge out of that animation. And so it's that. Well, they interrupted me, but it would have been pretty sweet. There we go. And then dodge cancel out, so I don't have to watch that whole animation. Dang it. The hell are you doing throwing me? Hello, Endzone123 in the chat. Nice to meet you. Unless we've met before, in which case, nice to see you again. So, Abyss Odyssey is still not showing up in the list of games on Twitch, but, like, it's weird. It's not in the drop-down. So, like, it's not a game that I can select, but I can still click on it and see other videos of Abyss Odyssey that are on Twitch, so I don't know what's going on with it. Man, being poisoned is just the worst. I think I'm going to use my antidote. So I don't have to be poisoned for another 7 seconds. I've been here a long time ago on the Isaac stream. Oh, well, cool. Good to see you again. Yeah, I have not streamed Binding of Isaac in quite a long time, so you have some old school cred there. I love it when they just block and just let that thing hit them. It's so satisfying. Getting a fully charged one of those hits in on this guy. By the way, I'm assuming my audio and settings and all that are good. If not, let me know. But, Pretty sure all that's good. I switched from XSplit to OBS. Like, I made that switch a while ago. I don't know if I mentioned it. But, I'm definitely liking OBS. Well, actually, I never used XSplit. I used FFSplit. And OBS is definitely preferable. Like, with FFSplit, I always had to worry that, like, my settings got messed up since the last time I streamed. And, never really had that issue with OBS. Aw, man. Ran out of cancel points. Dang it. Oh man, this block is going to block that attack so good. Dies. Yep. Pretty much. Have you played this end zone? I don't think many of my friends have gotten into this game yet. Which is fine, it's not for everyone. I mean, I didn't think it was going to be for me at first. My sayings give wisdom to some. Needs more Splatterhouse, says Justrop. I disagree. I find the combat in this game way more fun than Splatterhouse. 130? Not bad. I've also seen a snippet of a Splunky daily challenge stream. Yeah, I haven't done Splunky in a while either. I'll go back to it every now and then to do a daily, but I haven't streamed it in a while. That's another game I got most of the achievements in, and there are just a couple that are eluding me. I need the speedrunning achievement, the no gold achievement, and I'm sure there's one or two more. Well, let's see, I could use a health vial and buy one, or I think I'll just drop an antidote. I'd rather save my health vial until I really need it. Waiting on Crypt of the Necrodancer to release. I want to play it with my Pig Destroyer / Converge albums. Yeah, that game looks really cool. I am definitely interested in seeing how that plays. I haven't watched any videos of it or anything. I just heard people talk about it. Well, I could get a charm staff, but its damage is only 8, so I think I'll pass. You'll notice that I didn't do any preparations before I started this playthrough, and that's because I want to try to train myself not to rely so much on externalities. Like, I want to survive by the power of my own ability. I want my skill to be the deciding factor in my success. Which, you know, isn't saying I won't buy stuff in the dungeon, but you know, I want to get better at this game. The timing changes based on what song is playing. You can use your own music. Yeah, that's what I've heard. I definitely like games that let me use my own music, like Audio Surf. I was really bad at Audio Surf, but being able to play with my music oh man, wrong button. I tried to do an air special that I tried to do it again. It did not work out. And, I'd like to capture this guy. Actually, I think I will. Or I'll try anyway. Because if I do run into a creature that I haven't captured yet, that I'm sure of, it shouldn't take me that long to build up some more mana. Oh, I have a boss coming in as well. Glad I got a little bit of help with this. Rhythm-based dungeon crawling. Yeah, it's a crazy idea. But one that definitely appeals to me. It's a roguelike as well, isn't it? It's a rhythm-based roguelike. Oops. I don't know why I always want to hit select to switch to my critter. I'm pretty sure there's nothing else over here. I guess I can switch back until I get into another encounter. Okay. I just wanted to check and make sure that I didn't pick up a skill point. Now the real question is, will I be able to play Crypt of the NecroDancer with my DDR pad? That would be cool. It's been a long time since I've messed with that thing. You asshole. I mean, I know you're me, but you're still an asshole. I need to stop doing that Rothering attack. That's not a good attack. Wait, did I block that or not? Ugh. This is not working out very well. There, take a couple of those. There's that Rothro attack again. Oh my god! This guy will not let me get away. If it connects to the PC, maybe joy to key. Well, I have a... It's a PS2 dance mat, and I have a PS2 controller adapter, so, wow, 24 damage, level 3 fire, that's a better sword than those guys usually drop. But I should be able to just use my DDR pad as a joystick. I used to use it like that with Stepmania. Oh cool, there's a whole page on the NecroDancer website about dance pads. It's awesome. Unless the page says, no, we do not support dance pads. But I don't know why they would make an entire page for that. And I know I've captured, I have the undead people, so I don't have to worry about them. And I know I have that lady, that's Judith. Because I went into the, oh my god, I'm getting swarmed. I went into the training, and I took a look at some of the enemies, just to make sure that, I recognized all of them. And I definitely picked up Judith at some point. Poisoned! At least it's only 5 seconds. Not worth using an antidote on, I don't guess. I'm not playing as well as I did in my last playthroughs. Oh yeah, after I beat the warlock with the monk, I was going to do another playthrough with him, and I was about halfway through the dungeon, and the game crashed, which sucks. I gained a couple levels, and they didn't keep. It works with them apparently, but a company is putting out custom ones. Oh. That's interesting. Been a long time since dance mat games have been popular. I mean, I assume there's always like a small devoted group of people who still playing DDR and Stepmania. But it's not as mainstream as Guitar Hero and Rock Band were. I guess Guitar Hero and Rock Band, Jesus, are kind of back in the same boat that that DDR was in. Oh my god, you interrupted me out of that attack? I better use a health potion. And you grabbed me. Great. Yeah, if I'm going to do any sort of dance pad activity, I'm going to have to get in better shape. I am not in the kind of shape necessary to be up and stomping around. Actually, I shouldn't be stomping around anyway because they have downstairs neighbors. Like, I don't, I'd love to break out my Rock Band drums and play that every now and then. But since I'm living in a house with pretty thin walls and downstairs neighbors. I usually don't, out of respect for them. All right, Ultima Monk. So yeah, I'm going to have to get in better shape and find a better house/apartment. Last time I saw a DDR-style game was in Grandma's Boy. I don't think I've seen that one. Aw, man! Man, some of those patches of poison vines are really hard to jump over. I'm gonna have to look up some videos or something for Crypt of the Necrodancer because I still have no idea how that game works. Like, I'm assuming it's like a, Hey guy.
This is all I can do now. Kill any nearby monsters for me.
Man, in my last playthrough, those guys were giving me potions left and right. So I assume Crypt of the Necrodancer is like a tile-based kind of roguelike, like a NetHack or a Rogue, like the original Rogue was tile-based. You know, a very standard dungeon crawly type game, except that every time you move, you have to move in the rhythm to a song. So you would use like up, down, left, and right like you would a NetHack, but you would have to do it to a specific rhythm. I have no idea though. Alright, if I can do this challenge room, get my health up, I'll be in pretty good shape. Because full health, two potions, and a monster soul would be swell. Aw, man. It's too bad it's not the fire mummy. Because I learned that the fire mummies are extremely exploitable. Well, I guess this guy's kind of exploitable too, but not as exploitable. Oh no, it's a skeleton. Not as exploitable as the fire mummy. Because the fire mummy has these fire mines. Basically, he takes a step back and makes a fireball that floats in midair and just stays there forever, or until an enemy hits it. And the enemies have no idea what to do about the fire mines. So it's really easy to cheese them by just laying those over and over again. It's kind of easy to cheese them with the vomit as well, though. I really hate fighting against the skeletons. And you know, I know cheese isn't entertaining to watch. But this is kind of a critical battle for me, and I'm kind of mucking it up. Well, I used a potion. Might end up having been a waste, because, oh no. I don't like the peacock soldiers. Maybe I'll get lucky enough for the peacock soldier not to know how to handle me spamming the vomit. Oh no, another. Oh wait, that's a mummy. Okay. I thought it was another skeleton warrior. Oh crap. I should have used my other potion. I'm going to try and get a good stream going with OBS, BRB. Oh well, good luck. Oh man. I still haven't determined if you actually lose health for failing those. I mean, I'm pretty sure when I had full health, whenever I go into those challenge rooms with a lot of health, I always, like, don't have much health afterwards. But maybe because my health was already low, it didn't take much. Maybe it, like, takes a percentage or something. Or maybe it's just based on how much health you have. The AI is so cheesy. Yeah, it definitely can be. But it can also be really dumb, too. Let's see, we have an altar over here. Let's see if there's a shopkeeper. Yep. Potions? Plus 300 maximum health. That might be useful. I wonder if it gives me that health immediately. Like, if I got that, I wonder if I would have 860 instead of 560. It's not worth 20,000 gold, though. That's almost half of what I have, so you can keep it. My mana is almost full, so I should be able to capture another critter pretty soon. Aw, that's the boss level, too. Dang. You jerk. Nope. Went on ahead and used my potion. Because if you die, and a soldier has to come and rescue you, you lose all your potions anyway. So, might as well use it to stay alive a little while longer. That's a lesson that I had to learn the hard way. Because at one point, I had almost no health, and I was near an altar. And I was like, screw it, I don't want to use a potion. I just want to kill myself, since there's an altar right here. And I can just be revived instead of having to use my potions. And I did that, and I saw that I lost all my potions, and I had a sad. Shadow Catrian, eh? Oh no. Oh crap. Maybe I should use my AoE. Crap!
I'm coming to find you.
I should have used my capture ability, because you lose all your mana when you're revived as well. Hey, I was trying to pick up my friend's sword. Can't you have a little bit of honor? I should be able to cheese my way through this. Oop. Maybe you should face the direction that the enemy's in. You know, just a thought. She's being more susceptible to the shotgun than enemies usually are. Usually they just dodge right out of the way every time. Alright, well, can't backtrack to the altar, unfortunately, so nothing I can do but press forward. Oh, there's an altar right here. Nice. Wait, no, this is a devil altar. Crap! It does not help me. I cannot use one of Pinkoya's weapons. I can't use that Pinkoya's weapon either. I mean, I know you're trying to be generous, game, but I can't use that Pinkoya weapon either. You really want me to be playing Pinkoya right now, apparently. Ah, crap. I shouldn't have aggroed the ice elemental. This might go poorly, since that wasn't an altar. Ah, crap. I guess that guy's friends want to come and play. I was hoping they'd leave me alone until I could kill him, but does not seem to be the way they want to do it. Yes! Fire that direction. My turning around was less than precise because I was standing on ice. Oh, I somehow managed to miss with all of those attacks. I don't like fighting on ice. Well, oh man, is this the king? Ah, I am so screwed. There's no way I'm going to be able to kill the king with the shotgun guy. No, I leveled up at least. Alright, firefighter. You're in way over your head. Trying to get a preemptive shot there. Wait, what? Okay, that was some bullshit game. The cinematic ends and he's hitting me in the face. What the hell? Awesome. Just trying to get through you. These crows are gonna be a major annoyance if I don't take them out. I don't really have... Oh, there we go. I was gonna say I don't really have a good up attack, but that took out a couple of them. Alright, if I can jump over the horse. Crap, I was trying to isolate the king. Get those crows out of the way so I could. Yeah, he doesn't want any of that shotgun. Hey, I canceled him out of his horse attack. That's something, I guess. Man, there's an arena right after this too. So if I can pull this out of my ass, because if you have an arena room when your main character is dead, if you succeed at the arena, your character automatically revives with no alter necessary. Alright, well, I got the achievement with the monk, but kind of want to take another shot at that. I'm going to quit out of here and start a new game just so I have a new map. Because I did not like that map. There we go. That's a lot more easy rooms. And still plenty of arenas as well. What I ought to do though is go down the middle path. Well, I'm still probably not high enough level to fight Paganini. Maybe I should bring Catrian in, try to capture the higher level enemies. I don't really like this game. I like the theory behind it. I just don't like the combat. I like the combat. I don't like when I don't like when you get cheesed, which I mean when I do really well at this game, it feels really rewarding, you know? Like, it's very satisfying when I do well. When I don't do well, I imagine it's frustrating for everyone involved. And all of the monk's charm weapons are like super low damage.
I can't I didn't have an antidote. I'm a goner.
Hey, mana potion. That's pretty good. I'm going to go ahead and use that now. Man, a lot chest should at least have a mana potion in it. It doesn't have to have a health potion every single time, but come on. Give me something besides money and mana orbs. Out of cancel points. Wait, what kind of bracelet was that? Burn damage, huh? Interesting to find that just lying around in a chest. I probably won't stream this game too many more times. I just wanted to do a couple more streams before I was fully done with it. I'll probably try getting the Nightmare Achievement once or twice during a stream. If I do that, I hate to say it, but I'll probably have to play with Pinkoya. Like, she's super cheap, but I don't think I'll be able to do Nightmare Mode with any other character. Man. Yes. Face that direction. Huh, the barrier disappeared again. That's weird. As long as you stream, it doesn't matter what you play. Oh, well. Thanks. I have a lot of free time this weekend, so I'll probably stream at least one more time. Maybe twice. I might do another poll and see what people would like to see. I could do another FTL game, but I kind of got the feeling that a lot of people found that boring to watch because it was a lot of, like, you know, analysis of the game and, you know, talking about what I was doing and not just talking about random stuff. Which, you know, some people like the deep analysis and don't like me talking about random stuff, so no matter what I do, there's going to be people bored by it, but I just kinda have to do what I find fun, I guess. I still have not found an enemy that I haven't captured yet. So I don't know what the hell I'm missing. Nice. A splatter house. That's okay. I think I've played enough Splatterhouse for one lifetime. I mean, not that I dislike Splatterhouse, you know, I mean, I like it in theory. I am just terrible with those games. Like, any kind of traditional beat-em-up? Like, not like this. This is really more of a, it reminds me of, like, a character action game like Devil May Cry or something, only it's 2D instead of 3D. I mean, really, I guess it's like, I don't want to say a fighting game, because you're not really doing combos per se. Like, I'm not doing, like, quarter circle forward or down back forward or anything. Well, I guess people call Smash Brothers a fighting game, so I guess that's basically what this is. But, like, any traditional side-scrolling beat-em-up where... where I don't know what the hell I'm supposed to be doing. Like, I don't know how to be good at those games. Okay. Can you capture those POS crows? You know, I wondered if maybe, like, the small enemies floating around can be captured, but I'm pretty sure they can't. Because A, playing as those enemies would not be very much fun since you would die in one hit. And B, there's not enough spaces on the select screen for all of the small enemies. I almost tried it. I almost tried using my capture ability on like a spider or something. But I figured that would just be a waste of mana. Take that health file. Alright, how am I doing here? Okay. Not a moderate coming up, but I should be okay. If I start really getting hurt, I'll go ahead and use my mana on something. Aw, you jerk. I do like me some golems. Damn, maybe I should have done some damage to this guy first. I don't want the capture effect to wear off before I can kill him. There we go. Oh man, that's a poison weapon? That's not very nice. I really like the trot sound effect for the Pudutars. It's a really satisfying clip-clop kind of sound. Well, let's see, do I want curse time or fire damage? I don't have either of those weapons, so I would kind of prefer extra fire damage. Because I'm more likely to find a fire weapon that does a lot of damage than a curse weapon that does. Oh, she's not having a good day with those spikes. Well, that was the wrong attack for that situation. Man, it is giving me nothing but Pinkoya weapons, I swear to God. Man, that one human-sized arm still kind of creeps me out. I saw someone over here. Oh, man! I have not got a good hit with my windup yet. They always manage to hit me or dodge at the last second. There we go. Ow. Yeah, I threw that guy through the wall.
I killed many monsters, but this is as far as I'll go. Those skeletal soldiers. They're everywhere.
I know, right?
I wish I could fight by your side.
They're a pain in the ass. Oh, good. Another trophy. Seems like whenever I stream, all they want to give me is trophies. Like, not even a bag of gold. Man, I am not comboing very well today. I cannot combo that attack into... Oh wait, well, I'm out of cancel points. That would partially explain it. I guess you have to stand still for those to come back. I never really noticed that they don't come back if you're moving or attacking. There we go. Man, that was a good attack. 3 with 1 blow. Alright, bunch of easy rooms. That's what I'm talking about. I like my games like I like my eggs. Over easy. Actually, over easy eggs are pretty gross. I prefer all of my eggs to be cooked, such that the yolk is no longer liquid. Like, a partially liquid yolk really grosses me out. But yes, I like my games the opposite of how I like my eggs. Of course, I guess I prefer scrambled eggs, and I don't know what the opposite of scrambled is. I guess the whole egg metaphor was kind of a bad idea from the beginning. You jerk. Giving me a lot of Pudutars. Not complaining, they're pretty easy to deal with, relatively. As soon as I say that, one's gonna start kicking my ass. It's the law of streaming video games. As soon as you say something's easy, you're going to get wrecked by the very thing you dismissed. Boiled. Yeah, there we go. I like my games hard boiled. I guess that would be like a detective game. Like LA Noir or something. That's a hard boiled story.
My sayings give wisdom.
Huh. Voice sample screwed up. I guess I went through that dialogue a little too quickly. Oh no. I was playing earlier, and I talked to the guitar player while I was poisoned, and I took damage while he was in the middle of his dialogue, and he actually had different dialogue for when that happens. I was pretty amazed. I don't know why I wasn't using him. I took poison damage while he was giving his advice, and he said, I'm sorry, son, knowledge comes at a price, or something like that. And I was like, wow, it's really cool that they actually thought ahead for that. Now I want some boiled eggs. Yeah, hard-boiled eggs are great. Soft-boiled eggs, again, It has the whole liquid problem. Of course, you know, some people like that. I need to get some distance between me and these jerks. Oh wait, maybe I can make them fall in the pit. That'd be pretty cool. There we go. That's the honorable way to win a fight. Just wait for them to jump to their deaths. I'm gonna make sure I didn't miss anything before I go to the boss. This isn't Verbum Dei, is it? I don't think so. I think it was just one of the nightmare bosses. Yeah, there's nothing else back here. Okay. I really like how the key is on your person somehow, like no matter what form you're in. Like the idea of this big rock golem with a gold key dangling around his neck. I don't know. It's really, it's the little details like that that make a game memorable, you know? Boy, you really want to curse me, don't you? Okay. Let baby have his bottle, I guess. Ow. I mean, I should be able to block that curse attack every time since he telegraphs it so far in advance. But, I'm not always quick enough on the button. It'd be really cool if I could get away from this fucker. Damn it. I was really hoping he would walk into my waiting fist. Yeah, Stone Golem. Too slow for that kind of fight. I could capture this guy, I guess. I should be high enough level to get him. Uh-oh. Hope he doesn't jump over that. Nope. Okay. I mean, it's kind of sucks to have just the nightmare version of the same person. But at least I can, like, directly compare the two now. Yeah, nightmare version is definitely slower. I don't like that. That curse ball. Yeah, can't wind that attack up for nearly as long. Oh well, it's a health bar. That's the important thing. I like how the nightmare version of the Ghost Monk has a more human form than the Ghost Monk himself. Like, the real Ghost Monk is kind of just an amalgamation of, like, of skeletal features in a robe. And the Nightmare Ghost Monk has actually one human skeleton. So it's a little more normal, ironically. Oh man, I blocked, but it was too late. Yeah, the projectiles just don't combo into anything. That's what's wrong with them. That's why I never use projectiles with the three main characters. Because it's just pointless. All you're doing is screwing yourself out of something that works with your other abilities. Oh yeah, great. So I was watching some of the LPR Grimith R. He was playing Rogue Legacy during a live stream, and he's been posting that in individual episodes on his channel. That's Grimithr, and that's been pretty entertaining. Kind of what put me in the mood to do a little streaming myself. Rogue Legacy is a heck of a game. I didn't really give it... I mean, I played it. I played it to death, but I didn't really play it on stream that much. That's not a potion, is it? Are my eyes playing tricks on me? Yeah. Yeah, there's no potion. You're just part of that plant. Okay.
I'm glad you found me before the shopkeeper. I managed to take...
I should go back and do another full Rogue Legacy playthrough one of these days. I played it during a stream a few times, but it was always like in the middle of my current save, and it wasn't sequential or anything. Like I beat some bosses all out of order and stuff, so. I didn't realize it was back to the normal me. Because apparently the wounded soldiers don't really like talking to monsters. The shopkeepers will talk to monsters. Like, you don't have to switch back to talk to a shopkeeper. But the soldiers, you need a real person. Grimith uses hitbox. Yeah, I'm debating just using hitbox all the time, but then there are a bunch of people who probably don't have hitbox accounts, and they would have to sign up for a new account to chat, and it would just be a big pain in the ass for them, and they might not bother, and, you know, I don't want to lose my current audience. See? This guy will talk to a nightmare person. Okay. You also can't mess with your skills in nightmare form. I don't know, hitbox does seem better than Twitch in a lot of ways. I guess also I'm still worried that the site will experience problems down the line. Like, it seems to be working fine now, but it doesn't really have the same infrastructure that Twitch has as far as working for a long period of time. How's my mana? I'm about a quarter of the way full. Wow, she tossed me into a trap. That's insidious. That was pretty impressive. I've been lazy about doing the chat captions on the last couple videos, because there haven't really been that many chatters. I didn't even sync this one up because I wasn't really expecting anyone to show up. But I'll go back and put the captions on the other two. Also, the projectile attacks are just so slow, the enemies always dodge them. I guess this isn't really a projectile-based game. Did I go to that devil altar down there? I forget. Well, I guess not, but it's just a pole arm. I haven't seen any secret passages. There have been walls that I probably should have been checking. I tell you what I kind of like to stream. There we go. But it probably wouldn't make a very good stream is the Dragonfall expansion for Shadowrun Returns. I finished the main campaign in Shadowrun Returns pretty recently, and I played like the first 5 minutes of Dragonfall, but I haven't really gotten into it yet. But I really love the Shadowrun games, but I think they'd be bad for streaming. Because, you know, they're very text heavy. And no one wants to hear me read aloud, but then I might read too fast, and some people, it wouldn't be an enjoyable experience. I don't know. Couple mummies, huh? One of each. A fire and a vomit. Oh, that's right, she has this poison ball thingy. That's kind of cool. Doesn't really, like, seek the enemy out or anything, it just kind of goes in a preset path. Oh, I can cancel out their projectiles with it. That's pretty cool. Hey, shouldn't I be immune to poison or something? Since I have a poison attack? Isn't that how it works? I like that she has a dive kick. Judith, new secret unlockable character in Dive Kick, coming 2015. Yes, face that direction. Aw, man. Played right into his trap. Nice. And she can jump really high, too. Which is a good feature to have when one of your attacks is a dive kick. Like, look at that. I can jump to the ceiling. See how they just dodge my projectile every single time? Well, yeah, they proved me wrong. Hey now, this was going very well until I started being proud of my fighting ability. Then it all went to hell. How much health? Okay. I should be able to do this without a potion. Phew! Good hustle, good hustle. Do I want to switch? Yeah, I think I'd rather use her than the Nightmare Monk. She doesn't have nearly as much health, but she's way faster, and I prefer having two unique sets of abilities to having two similar sets of abilities where one is totally inferior. Hey, stop stabbing me. It's really painful. That's kind of a lousy special. You have to get way too close for that to be effective. I'm gonna just dive kick you to death instead of using my specials. What was that? I don't think I should have gotten hit there. Yep, dodge, of course. There are two universal truths in this game. Blocking will just make sure they throw you, and throwing a projectile will just make sure they dodge. Those are the two noble truths of Abyss Odyssey. You're now ready for whatever this game has to throw at you. So the mask, the Warlock's mask, is still only halfway destroyed. There hasn't been any progress on that since the last time I played. I do have two wins on the leaderboard now, so I guess they fixed that glitch, but it's kind of disappointing since I should have about six. So, I have not contributed much to the destruction of the seal. I think the highest person on the leaderboard has like over 100 Warlock kills, which is nuts. I think they must be, they might be haxing just a little bit. I mean, I guess theoretically, someone might have beaten this game 100 times, but man, they must have no job to have that kind of time. I guess it could be a kid on summer vacation or something. I have a skill point, but I'm pretty happy with my with my skills here. But I went ahead and pump it into something. Just it's that one, right? Yeah. Just to get it out of my inventory. All right, a full stock of health files, full health, almost full mana, full cancel points, which. I guess that's nothing special, but still. Oh wait, is this the king? No. I can always tell when it's the king because... Oh, it's this guy again. Because there are crows flying around. Like, before you even get to the boss chamber. Well, that wasn't the block button. That was. Man, I reflected it right back at him, and it didn't affect him. Which I guess makes sense. And he has a poison weapon. Great. Poison is not good for abilities with a huge wind up. I mean, I was complaining that the Nightmare Monk isn't as good as the real monk, but I guess I shouldn't be, because I wouldn't want this fight to be harder. You dick. God, the bosses are hard enough when they don't have a special weapon. It's not fair that you can poison me and curse me. I can't do diddly squat to you. Fine, I'll use a potion. Ooh. Well, at least that's a pretty good sword again. Ah, man. That went kind of south. See, is this ice or just a barrier? I think it's ice. Yep. The normal barriers look pretty similar to the ice barriers in this level, so I wanted to be 100% sure. Fire upgrade or curse upgrade? Well, once again, I don't have either, so I guess I'll just stick with fire. It gives me the higher vanilla weapon bonus as well. Yeah, there's nothing else up there. Nice. Not so nice. Ooh, jackal. I'll take you. Wow. That was grade A bullshit. You can't move while your AoE attack is going off. And as soon as the animation ended, it was just a disaster. I don't like the jackal. I mean, I like playing as a jackal. I don't like fighting against the jackal. I mean, how are they both able to immediately attack me after I use the capture ability? Yeah, who's cheesing now? Pick up this health globe. Screw you, breezy fish. Oh yeah, great. Because the game cheats. Yeah, apparently. I should go over to the right here. Nope. Not a dang thing. Well, we have another arena coming up, so with luck, I might be able to get my health back. Oh man, this is not a very good place to fight enemies. Of course, if I'm lucky, they'll get so hung up on the trap that they won't be able to touch me. Enemies are not good at dealing with traps of any kind. Oops. I guess I'm not really good at dealing with traps either. Alright, getting pretty close. And there's a couple easy rooms after this, so that'll take some of the pressure off. I'm not exactly sure how the healing works. I'm not sure if it always heals your main character or if it heals whoever the active character is. So just to be safe, I'm going to switch over to the monk. Nice. Haven't been skelly in a while. Mummy and her. I forget what her name is. Hmm. So you look at that immaculate dodging of my fireballs. See, that's what's nice about the Fire Mummy, because his fire mines are undodgeable. I mean, the enemies could jump over them, but they're too stupid to realize they can do that, so it works out well. And of course, I can just jump over them all day long. Except when I combo myself into them. That's not very much fun. The fireball just went... Oh no, it disappears after a while. Okay, good. Oh man, I don't have any potions either, so I'm gonna have to step my game up. Balta, eh? Or Bota. B-A-U-T-A is how you spell that guy's name. I don't know how to say it. Whew. Oh crap. Well, I should be fast enough to deal with this stone golem, hopefully. If I play my cards right. Well, that would have been nice if I comboed it into the right move instead of the fireball. See if I can get a little fireball cheese off since this guy's so slow. Oh, I got a few hits in on him. Okay, I guess they don't always dodge projectiles. Alright, I get to play Skelly now. That'll be fun. Of course, it helps that the skeleton can throw fireballs super fast, like way faster than Catrian can throw them. So it's easier to spam them. But comboed into the wrong move again. Oh hey, Sore Thumb, what's up? Wreck that wizard this time. I'll try, man. I wrecked him right before I started streaming. Or not right before, but a little bit before I started streaming. Hey, level up. I like that the leveling in this game is fairly regular. Like, when you're higher level, it doesn't necessarily take longer to level up than when you're lower level. Hey, potion just sitting around in a crate. I'll take it. Oh, wait. Guitarman was back here. I think, huh? Maybe not. I'll just stand back and let them be confounded by that ice trap. Of course, not that it does any good against an ice golem. Can't do the fireball in the air. That's something that Catrian can do. I mean, I can sort of. Like, if I double jump and do it at the apex, it's not very, not very consistent, though. Oh, I get... Oh, he's probably down below me, and I can just hear the music because I was in the same general horizontal position. Yep, here he is. Now let's see, there was a gate around here somewhere, right? It looked like it just led to the... Oh wait, it's down there. It looks like it just leads to the exit, but I'll take a look. Oh no, there's a box. Oh, that's right. I'm on the leftmost path. Of course there's no exit over there. Oh, I could fight Verbum Dei if I wanted to, but I don't really have a reason to. Alright, arena number 3. And I am this guy. Bolta or Balta or... However the hell you say, whatever the hell his name is. A couple of sea witches. You know what you always find right next to a sea witch? A sandwich. Oh, 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 oh. Oh man. That is one for the ages. Matter. Are my daggers not intimidating to you? And a mummy. Not too bad. Not a bad group of monsters at all. See, once again, a stupid dagger toss just does not combo with anything. Alright, I don't want to switch, do I? No, I'd much rather stay as the skeleton than the Bota. Nice to see Duke has more late night company than little old me. Yeah, thanks for showing up, guys. It's really nice to have an audience, even if it is, you know, a small one. You know, I wasn't expecting any audience this late, so I am pleased as punch. I could buy a mana vial. Nah, my mana's almost full anyway. course, the mana vial might be useful for later, but I shouldn't need it at this stage. Not gonna get me in your fire trap. Ah, crap. I was gored. I have been gored. Yon skeleton has been gored. Aw, man, it got all framey. Skeleton is definitely one of the top tier enemies you can get. I'd say skeleton, no particular order, but skeleton, jackal, wood golem, stone golem are probably my faves. After them, I don't know, mummy's pretty good. Fire mummy's great if you can get his cheese working. But, you know, I prefer a character I can be skillful with to one I can cheese with. Of course, Verbum Day is a top tier character, but you're not very likely to pick him up during the course of a game. I wouldn't be high enough level to capture him anyway. At my current level. Well, that skeleton didn't last as long as I would have liked. Man, it sucks having to get used to how a new character controls after you, or how your character controls after you've been playing a monster for a while. Oh yeah, that's right, I have a poison sword. I haven't used it since I picked up the skeleton. Man, 30 seconds of poison, that must be because it's level 3 poison. 10 seconds for every level. I assume that's how it works. Oh, that didn't work. Hey. You know what would be helpful? Not another trophy. I'm not the cheat. You don't need to give me so many dang trophies. That's a Homestar Runner reference for anyone not familiar. Supposedly Homestar Runner is making a comeback. There's some interview or something with the creators where they said they were going to start producing Homestar Runner cartoons on the rig again. Which I'm pretty excited about. If I can build up a little more mana, I can capture another skeleton. But I don't think that's gonna happen before the skeleton die. Jesus. I do not like these face traps. They are not fun. They do not add a fun dimension to this game. And I just had to use all my potions. And I'm at 99 health. Oh my god, I am so screwed. Hoping for a secret passage. How much longer to the boss? Two more? Well, at least the next two stages are moderate. Hopefully there's an altar in one of these levels, so when I inevitably die, I'll be able to revive right away. That's what killed me on the last run. I had a devil altar instead of a normal one. That still sounds weird to me, pronouncing it altar. I always want to say altar. But that sounds weird to me too. I guess when you talk enough, like when you talk for a long period of time, eventually every word starts sounding weird to you. Oh hey, full mana. Skeleton is mine. I gotta make sure it doesn't fall into that bottomless pit.
Monk, I'm coming to find you.
Can I pick up a soul when... I don't think I can I? With the soldier? Oh, I guess I... Okay, I think I could pick it up and it'll just show up in my inventory once I revive, hopefully. Yeah, it's in my inventory, it's just not available. Nice. Alright, now to get past this trap. Oh wait, I guess I should pick up my sword too, huh? At least some guy showed up to help me out. That doesn't seem to happen very often these days. I already checked that wall, right? Yeah. Oh man. Alright, I need to hop on that moving platform. And I'm gonna have to be very nimble to get through here. Oh crap, I can't stand there. No, no, stop. Oh my god. Oh well. That could have gone worse, I guess. Oh no, it's a devil. It's a devil altar. I am in trouble. I really wish you could just revive people at the devil altar. Because, I mean, when there's a devil altar on a level, it replaces the normal one. So, I'm not going to be able to revive at all on this level. What happened to my soldier buddy? Did he die already? He was fighting with me just a second ago, wasn't he? God, what a useless special. That freaking chest bump thing. I don't know what the hell. What the heck that's supposed to be. That move. Well, it worked there because the enemy jumped at the precise right time. But normally. Normally the chest bump is not great. Of course, Skeleton just had to get another few hits in. Every single weapon is a freaking pink oil weapon. And now I'm going to have to... Oh wait, no. I don't have to go back. Oh, there you are. Wow, thanks for the help. Really appreciate the backup there, buddy. Oh, great. Alright. Potion would be nice. You've got to be shitting me. That thing is stuck there. Because of that soldier. Okay. Crap. I hate those faces. I didn't even see that one.
When you pay.
1 XP. Yep. That one seems to always give you 1 XP. Oh no. Fuck you. Oh my god. I need to just stop trying to get those skulls. There's nothing over there. That's not a secret passage. God damn it. Why don't I ever listen to myself? Alright, altar. Altar. Platform. Podium. Yes. Oh, thank you, God.
You're alive. I get. I'm in the warlock. This helps our. I will.
Yeah. Don't have to give me the whole spiel every time. Although I do appreciate it. Is it spiel or spiel? That's not like a Yiddish word, right? I think it's just spiel. Or I don't know, it might still be Yiddish. I just forget if it's an S or an SH. I should call Steven Spielberg, he would know. Wow, what's with... Is this platform supposed to be moving or something? I can... If you hold down and jump, it's a super jump, by the way. I just never... Or not super, but it's a slightly higher jump. I just never encountered a situation where I had to use it. Crap, I should have gone. Wait, that's right! I have a summon. Oh, thank God. Health. Glorious health. Wonder if I can trick those guys into jumping. Yeah, there we go. I like how their health orbs that they drop just kind of materialize where I can reach them when they jump to their death. Oh, that's a face. Totally missed that. This has been another very stingy playthrough when it comes to giving me the health potions. Something else that seems to always happen when I'm playing during a stream. Wow, two of these guys? This is... I have some backup, so that's nice. Of course, he's already halfway dead. Skeletons are not to be trifled with. Fortunately, that includes me. It is kind of embarrassing when the soldier is better at dodging a fireball than I am. Wow, that's weird. A crow just hanging out. Not near, Verbum Dei. Just a random crow. Alright, well this is it. I have a pretty healthy skeleton and a pretty healthy self. And I have one health potion, and I'm going to pick up another one. Alright, let's switch back to the monk for all this health gathering. Katrian had a different dialogue for the warlock, but with the monk it seems to all be pretty much the same. That was weird. He canceled out of his fish attack. I don't think I've ever seen that happen before. I've learned that when he's doing that fish attack, it's a good opportunity to get a free hit in on him, because normally he always does the whole attack, but I guess occasionally he can cancel out of it. Too far away to get a hit on him that time. Normally I just kind of do a down attack like that. Crap. Yes, corner me and then vomit fish at me. You're the worst final boss ever, you know that? Aw, it was only 15 seconds. No fair. I guess this guy has like some sort of poison resistance, if not poison immunity. I jammed on the block button, but was not fast enough. Nice. Crap. Going ahead and pop a potion now. If I die while I still have potions, I will be very, very cross. He canceled out of his fish attack again. You're confusing me, Warlock. You're changing up your strategy. Phew! I almost got the full brunt of those fish. Phew! So, supposedly, your ultimate goal is to actually wake the warlock up. Because that's the warlock lying there. Just before you can get close enough to him, I guess his power kind of prevents you from doing anything to him, and he just sends you back to the surface. So, I guess once the warlock is defeated enough times, maybe it'll unlock like another phase of the warlock or something, so you can actually wake him up to get to truly beat the game. I don't know. To be honest, the way they're handling the whole community content thing, I don't know how good it is. I mean, it's kind of cool, I guess, but it does not really feel like the community is playing a huge part in doing anything. You know, it's like occasionally the developers were just like unlock some stuff. It doesn't really feel like related to your ability or the number of wins you have at all. So you look at how much health the warlock has at 38. And here's Katrien at 48 with less, and then Pinkoya at 48 with much less. I'm gonna switch to Pinkoya and see if I can get into a fight with a living creature. Because I did a pretty good job of taking him out last time. It's just... he jumped over my, capture ball. Need a lift? So where? Grab your belongings. It's kind of annoying how... need a lift. So how infrequently this guy spawns, too. I don't think he's ever spawned in the cathedral before. No. Need a lift? So I don't know... Let's be off. I don't know if sitting here grinding this will actually make it more likely for him to show up or not. Probably not. Find it odd that you still have human hands with no body. Who, the monk? Yeah. The monk is a real mystery. Oh well, I guess that'll about do it for tonight. Our struggle against the warlock continues. Hey, I've almost caught up to Pinfeldorf. Even though I've actually surpassed his score by a couple. It's just... it didn't count the first few for some reason. Not that I'm bitter or anything. Yeah, thanks for watching, those of you who did watch, whether live or on YouTube later. I'll probably stream something on Saturday. Maybe something on Sunday as well, I don't know. All I have left to do in this game is Nightmare Mode. And Nightmare Mode is going to be a heck of a thing. I don't know if I have what it takes or not, but we'll see. I'll find something else to stream as well. I'll do a Shovel Knight run sooner or later, but I don't know if that'll be this weekend. I don't know. I'll figure something out. Anyway, good night, everybody.